Hello. So this is the second part. It's still day one, but I've made some progress with Ansible, and I'm learning it from scratch, really. I have dabbled with it in the past, but really that's a distant memory. So what we're going to be doing is experimenting with Ansible, and I've got two Cisco Catalyst 3750 switches up and running, configured as a stack. And what we're going to do is, rather than just doing show config, we're actually going to edit the config. And we're going to be doing it using a text file rather than the convoluted way. So when I say the convoluted way, I mean actually writing all of the key value pairs in the playbook. So if you're not familiar with a playbook, it's a YAML file which runs from Ansible. And I think if you had watched the earlier video, you'd see the kind of the documentation that I just briefly ran over. Run your first command and playbook. So it's written in Python, so it's a framework rather than Python, rather than bare Python code. And I found this example. This got me up and running with actually configuring the hosts. So you configure a hosts file, and that's got all the IP addresses. And you can break those up into groups. So you could have routers in a group, switches in a group, firewalls in a group, and so on, servers in another group. Then you need to make sure you can SSH in to your device. Just check that with, let me come out of this. So you would need to just SSH. If you're on Linux, then it would be something a bit like, I'm on the wrong window. Let me do it from this one. I've already typed it in, and it's because I've got Diffie-Hellman. Excuse me, because I've got a Diffie-Hellman issue, then I'm having to put this in. But if you've got newer switch, you can just do SSH space admin, and then at your IP address. So now I'm connected to the switch, SSH'd on. Clear. Oh, sorry. I thought I was still in Linux. Right, so let's just do show run. So this is on the Cisco switch. This is Cisco switch configuration, Cisco IOS. And there you can see I've got some VLANs that I added already using Ansible. So what we'll do is we'll add some more. So we've got VLAN 1, 2, and 3, virtual LANs. And playbook one, which was just the playbook which was just displaying the output. And the reason I'm showing you this is because it uses IOS command. Now that comes from well, Red Hat write Ansible, but they don't maintain all of the third-party modules. So the third-party modules you have to download from Ansible Galaxy. So Ansible Galaxy. Basically, it's their version of the App Store, but it's for Ansible. So there we go, Ansible Galaxy. And you've got networking, cloud, database monitoring, playbook bundles, and search. So because I'm doing Cisco, that's what I search for. But I mean, you could search for AWS or anything, whatever. So there we go, Cisco. And you can run it from the command line. And I think the one I ran was just the basic Cisco 34 collections. Oh, you can see the frequency of the download. Oh, IOS XR. IOS, there we go. 44,000. No, that's 500,000 downloads. Wow. Right, enough about Ansible Galaxy, galaxy.ansible.com. Let's show you some code, or some YAML at least. That was my second playbook, which I found the code for this from. I started experimenting with Ansible Vault, but we'll save that for another day. That's how you can hide your keys, or sorry, your your credentials, your passwords, and so on. Right, third playbook. And close the second and all the others. Right, so third, this is YAML file.yml. And name, send the config from text file. You can put whatever you want in there. Hosts switches. That matches, if you saw the previous video, it matches, if I cd to etc. Ansible, and then if I beam into hosts, there you see, can you see I'm highlighting just there, switches, in the green writing at the bottom. So switch one, Ansible underscore host equals 192.168.1.7. That's the address that accepts SSH connections, transport input SSH on my Cisco switch. So just close that. Gather facts, false, you don't want to show the running config or anything. Tasks, that's, so everything is a task. You do, this is just to get a name, get the info. IOS config, so that matches what you will find as an example in the documentation from Ansible for Cisco IOS. If it's IOS XR, then it would be a different command here. So this needs to match or be the correct syntax, the correct method for your switch. Now, source src equals, this is a text file. It's not even YAML. So I'm, as always, I try and resist being coerced into using a framework entirely where possible. If I can avoid it, I will. So all we want to do here is lower 3750new.txt. And yeah, this, if you are familiar with Cisco, this is the Cisco command. This is what you would type. Or rather, it's actually what you would type if you were editing the text file, which you were then going to upload to or merge with the device. You couldn't just type this on the, well, you could just paste this in the command line. But if you were typing it line by line, you'd have to do interface VLAN 3, hit enter, and then do description demo, and hit enter IP address, because it takes you into different configuration modes. The exclamation at the mark, the exclamation mark at the end is just kind of like a comment in the configuration treats it as a comment, just as like a line spacing. So what we'll do is we'll still use that because it just keeps the config looking nice. Even if we don't put that exclamation mark in, I think it's the IOS would update that with the config anyway. Right, demo description. Let's call it production. And we'll change that to VLAN 4, can be 4.1. In actual fact, we've already got 3, so we don't really need to do that. So we've got 3 VLANs already. Let's add VLAN 5 as well. So let's call it dev. Development VLAN, this is VLAN 5. And VLAN 6, production dev, we can just call this anything we want really, but let's call it research, it's just a name. Okay, good, so I'll just change that to 6. So we've got text file, and this is exactly what we would paste in if we were just going to paste it into a Cisco router manually as a human being. As I say, you go into different modes, but if you've laid it out like this, you just paste it in. Okay, so this is the playbook that we're going to run. So this is important, and this is important. So line 4 and line 9 are very specific. That's just the local, the path to the file. So if you're in VS Code, you can get the relative path. You just need to get the relative path. So you can copy path or copy relative path. Copy relative path gives you that. If you copy, If you just copy path, it'll give you a full path, which is fine. But if you are on a different machine, it may not work, almost certainly won't work. Right, good. Okay, let's run it. So what we're going to do is we are going to say, I don't know where that's there, that across. Ansible-playbook. I know what I'll do first before. Let's go back to the previous directory. I've not got my virtual environment running, which is source activate. Now we can do. In fact, what I'll do, let's just do it in the main. So yeah, we've seen that we've just got VLANs 1, 2, and 3 there. So if I exit out of here. Right, virtual environment is now correct. And right, so Ansible playbook, third playbook. Just check it's called that. Yep. So what it's going to do is it's just going to pass this, and when it gets to line 10, it's going to go and look for lower 3750 new.txt, not the copy. And yeah, let's run it. Oh, third playbook could not be found. Oh, go up one directory, now try. That's better. It takes, that's pretty quick. So you get this message each time. I'm not sure how to make that go away. If any of you know how to make that yellow, annoying yellow message go away, then drop me a comment. So it's switch one, okay, changed, okay, one, changed one. I think that's per block. So anyway, let's go back in and SSH back into the switch, and we should see, instead of VLANs 1, 2, and 3, we should see VLANs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. What it hasn't done, there we go. So it's transferred that config from from here. So this was text file on my laptop, and now we are looking at configuration on this switch. So there we go, editing switch configuration using Ansible from a Linux laptop. And it's as simple as that, really. Obviously, there's way more to it, using variables, using Vault, doing it on multiple devices. Say, at the moment, I'm just kind of breaking the ice, really. So we've just got switches added in the host file. Because I'm using real hardware, I don't have a lot of devices to actually add, so it may hit a brick wall there. But really, I think the important thing to learn just from this video really is the fact that you just need to make sure that you go to Ansible Galaxy, you get the correct Cisco module for Ansible, and then you use the correct syntax here. So if we look at, let's split this. So if we look at the two side by side, you'll see IOS command, so that's a method from the IOS Ansible module for Cisco, and that's a method, and so is that. So you just need to read the documentation and make sure you're using the right method, whether you're using IOS command or IOS config. There's many more which. So if you did want to actually just go and check the documentation, it's all here. And wow, you can see it's just been updated very recently, which is nice. So these are all the modules. And then you can go and look at config, command, interfaces. Some of them are being deprecated, so make sure you check the right OSPF, NTP, SNMP, static routes. Yeah, so deprecated, removed after the 1st of June this year. So you want to be using this one instead. So if you want to add static routes, this is the syntax. It'd be nice if I got an example here as well, wouldn't it? Here we go. Yeah. So this will only work if your device, if it's correct for your device. For instance, you've got VRF there, so you need to be on a device. You need to be on the correct hardware for this syntax. There we go. So I can't demonstrate that to you because this is for a router, and I don't. Although I've got a layer 3 switch, I don't believe this will work. So this is kind of router specific. So all of this is just YAML. So it's not Python. It's not Cisco. It's just YAML. Okay, so I hope this has been a little bit more progress on the previous video for you. And really, I've seen videos on YouTube where people are actually sending keys and values where the key is the level of the config, and then the value is what you want to update. Whereas really, so in, it gets very... you get many, many more layers, and it's just unnecessary because you can just add this. If you know your Cisco config, you just add it into a text file and then you just run this. And if you're familiar with Jinja, what you could do is you could make all your templates and put them all in here. So then you can start using the pairs of curly braces as well. And you could use a specific text file. For instance, if you wanted to add VLANs 2, 4, 5, 6 to all of your switches, you'd use this text file. And if you wanted to also update all your routers with new interfaces, then you would do that separately, and then you would have a separate text file for the routers. So there we go. I'm blagging it a bit here, so I'll be back with another video once I've learned a bit more. So until then, take it easy.